Welcome my fellow Going Medieval fans! In this 4th player construction showcase, I have a special treat for you. Have you ever imagined what the castle from the game's main concept art would look like if built in the game? Well, imagine no more, because thanks to Lady Catelyn, you will see it in its full glory. My name is Peter, and besides this save file, I have also been sent several more from your fellow players, and you will see all of them in the future episodes of Player Construction Showcase. If you want me to show off your villager structure, send me the screenshots or even better the save file at the email address in the description, where you will also find the link to the previous episodes and all my guides and let's plays of Going Medieval. So let's jump straight into Lady Catelyn's settlement made in the image of the concept art for Going Medieval. As you can see, if you compare the two, she went into the details as far as the gameplay allows. She also completed the castle as it wasn't finished in the concept art image. So it is all there. The crop fields, the village in front of the castle's wooden palisade, the towers with banners, both on the palisade edges and the main keep, the huge flat-topped middle towers, the battlements, the roof on the other towers, and the main non-gated entrance from the village to the castle. Now let's visit the mines from where the villagers get their iron, limestone and clay. These are off to the side and one of them is even covered by a large structure. Next to these is an interesting concept, a number of pyres surrounded by traps. It's like, here you die raiders and here we burn your bodies. Cool level of efficiency. The defenses we can't see in the concept art image have been also added. These include an actual one tile wide ditch, two layers of fences and a layer of traps. This design goes all around the village, while the traps continue around the whole wooden palisade. Its towers are just for show and banners are a nice touch, but they serve no defensive purpose, something that the art designer didn't have to take into consideration. The palisade itself is 3 pillars deep and has openings for stairs for defenders to quickly get on top of it. You can see the interior design here, and it's hollow by the way. This back entrance is decorated by 9×7, so 63 metal traps and again handy pyres set right where the bodies of raiders will end up at. Let's next look at the village in front of the castle in more detail. The leftmost small buildings house woodworking workbenches, the kilns, and there are even two small homes. This is just a roof stockpile for clay and limestone, and next to it is another smaller food garden with several crops. The biggest building houses more workbenches on the ground level and large piles of linen and leather on shelves, along with more workbenches. The second floor has just some empty stockpiles. The middle of the village is dominated by 5 crop fields, all surrounded by tiles set as roads to speed up travel time. Here we have another home, complete with armor and weapon stands for 3 settlers. This graveyard here is the most detailed structure of this entire small village, starting with its entrance, the low wall, candles all over, and even roofed pillars which stand in for tombstones, all decorated with settlement's heraldry. We can see religious wall decorations and even bushes and red curtain shrubs. Another detail we can find is this small herb garden right below its cool looking clay brick terrace. So what do the rest of the buildings hold? This big one is another workshop, this one dedicated to armor and weapon crafting, while below its metals needed for crafting are smelted in 2 furnaces. The rest of the buildings are all actually homes, each having a bed, brazier, weapon and armor rack. Now there is just one more thing I want to show you here before we move on to the castle. It's a bit deeper under here. The food basement is set up in these long rooms with shelves on both sides, where the middle room is filled with many animal carcasses. Moving on to the main castle, it is faithfully representing the game's cover art and down to the minute details, like the tower walls being pulled back one tile and only the edges sticking out. The flat middle towers are another very noticeable feature, and in them we find guard stations with a bed and a brazier. The tallest inner towers also have all the features we can see on the concept art, from the battlements down to the banners. They are also hollow and have a staircase in them which leads to more guard stations. Features that are unique to this castle, as opposed to the concept art, are the side walls with many windows and these small gardens. Each one is decorated beautifully with plants, short walls, candles, and even stone stools so settlers can enjoy the sights and smells. The paths are also present and lead from one entrance to the next. Such gardens can be found on all four corners of the castle and are a great example of how you can combine in-game elements to make something unique to your settlement. On the top level of the main keep, we find a large stockpile of wooden sticks and even some clay and limestone bricks. Each of the four corners have a bedroom, and each bedroom has the elements we have seen before. Moving down one level, we find a huge room, two levels high, which you might think at first is a great hall, but when you notice all the bookshelves, you can conclude this is the main library. And when I zoom down one more level, this is confirmed by the presence of a research table in each corner with the addition of an apothecary workbench. Below this main library is another two levels high room, but this one is sort of a storage room. There are dozens of armor racks here containing all sorts of different clothing, while the corners are once again set aside for bedrooms. And this is a very interesting thing about this castle. It does not have a dedicated level for bedrooms, which is something we usually see in these showcases. The room to the side is an actual great hall, which is easy to notice because of all the ornamentation and deer heads mounted on the walls. There is even a second one on the opposing side. One other detail I would point out to you is just how intricate the heraldry design is with the elements and color combinations. What is on the lower floor are the two kitchens, one apothecary room and three armories. These contain weapon and armor racks filled with bows, while the two big kitchens have all the required elements and even coal for cooking meals. Below all this is the ground level central stone dining room with more corner bedrooms. It's also the location of the breweries, which interestingly enough hold only two workstations each. In the middle of the central dining room, we find a shelf with packaged food, and because the dining room is at the ground level, the doors here are with metal bars. You definitely don't see something like this every day. On the corner of the ground level, there are more bedrooms, another apothecary room, while the large side rooms are for entertainment and feature game tables. If you look at the foundations, we can see that this castle has no tunnels, dungeons, or underground rooms of any kind. Personally, I am disappointed that there wasn't at least a wine cellar or an escape tunnel just for the sake of some roleplaying. One thing I have skipped over are the small temples and churches at the bottom of outer towers next to the small gardens. Four in total, one at the base of each tower. Wherever there was some extra room left, it was used for storage and stockpiles. Some wood, sticks, barley and so on. One more thing I wanted to introduce into these showcases is to let you take a look at the statistics window. For this settlement, we can see that it was played on easier settings to make building it faster, and hillside map type was chosen so materials would be plentiful. The total playtime comes to exactly 20 hours and 341 in-game days. One settler was lost, and in 33 raids, 322 enemies were killed. This is by far one of the coolest castles and settlements I have had the pleasure of showcasing, and I think it opens the door for many more recreations of real or fantasy settlements. I can't wait to get another save file like this from one of you. And if you have been enjoying this showcase so far, please don't mind me reminding you to hit that like button, comment what was your favorite thing about it, and subscribe if you haven't already to get notified when I post new videos. Before I show you another major settlement, let's first look at some very interesting building projects. Hornsey Settlement by Ivanat0R features this massive clay brick cathedral complete with towers and even a small backyard. It's beautifully designed with many details, but what it sorely needs is more light sources, as clay bricks are such a dark colored building material. The inside is better lit and you can see what a difference that makes. I'm sorry I do not have more screenshots to show, especially because of how well made and furnished the inside of this cathedral is. There is an entire settlement in the background, and it is also made from clay bricks, but with wood too, giving it a very dark but also unique look, which I would love to showcase as most settlements are usually built with limestone bricks. It is not all finished, so I do hope to come back again and with a save file so I can do a video review of it. Now this other clay brick project will take your breath away. Starfort by Exergy is but one of several truly inspired and amazing building projects this player has constructed, and I will feature these in the next episodes, but for this one, I have picked this Star Fort. The inspiration came from this real-world fortification, Fort Bortenge, next to the village of Bortenge, Groningen, Netherlands. I know I mispronounced all of that, so I do apologize. It looks absolutely great, no matter during which season or weather we look at it. Exergy has managed to recreate its outer and inner shape, despite the fact that there is no water in Going Medieval, and that angled lines are impossible to make, so he has had to use zigzag patterns to mimic those. There are actual sloped walls made by using brick-tiled roofs, and a keep in the center of it several levels high. He even went as far as using different floor tiles to give us the feeling of different types of ground or water, which is of course easier to spot on the real-world fort. Making something this big is a massive undertaking on its own, but recreating something from the real world takes it to a whole new level of complexity. Now, as this is the holiday season, and in my hemisphere it's winter, I wanted to treat you to several shots of different settlements during winter. Some of these show only a fraction of the entire settlement, so I will show off the rest of those in future showcases. I don't know about you, but the winter weather in this game is really nicely animated and looks great, even with this art and graphic style which doesn't have many polygons. Next, I want to showcase a really interesting and unique settlement concept of Eagle's Nest by Starborn. This isn't his only pyramid, so my next episode will feature another similar project. Starborn's clay brick pyramid has 10 layers, but because it follows the natural formation of this mountain, it is not the same on all sides, nor is it hollow all the way through. But regardless, it's very symmetrical and has several nice decorations on the top and edges. It is also fully climbable, as there are stairs made of all types of materials set along its sides, and on the top levels, in the openings between those stairs, you will notice doors. Those doors lead inside into a fully underground village. Here you will find many large rooms, each specialized for a profession or storage of items. There is the room for kilns and furnaces, a brewery, blacksmithing and armor smithing, a huge stash of armor racks and weapon racks in separate rooms. Well, in fact, everything is huge. The bedroom section, great hall, food basement, library, game room, temple, church, and the rest of the workshops and storage rooms. Even the hallways are two tiles wide. An interesting detail is the fact that some rooms and hallways are made with clay bricks, some left with rough mined out stone, and others with limestone bricks, making it all much more colorful than if it was made with just one material. This next settlement has its own unique features, and I bet it will inspire you. It is called Amplefort by Vidovici, and it is this huge multi-story structure with several side annexes, a warehouse, and a number of pyres, covered by a roof at the back of it. The most unique feature are the angled crops and bushes in its large, beautiful garden. They are 3 deep, at a 45 degree angle, and surrounded by paths, low walls, and even trees. It is one of, if not the most beautiful garden I have seen any player build. Behind it are a tree grove and a huge hole, for which I can only guess that it is an old mine. The main structure is all limestone bricks, but highly decorated with torches, banners, niches on the ground level, and terraces with battlements on the higher levels. The entire complex is surrounded by a ditch, but with no walls. This fact alone makes it look less medieval and more post-Dark Ages. Coupled with all the beautifications, it's almost more like a Baroque-style settlement than a medieval one. There seems to be 6 different levels to the main keep, so I am really sorry I do not have any screenshots of the interior. An interesting thing are all the reinforced doors on the higher floors and balconies, as if raider paratroopers are gonna be landing on the top of the structure. There is a front entrance to the settlement, which is totally covered by traps, and there is also some sort of a back entrance through a mined out shaft, which is probably similarly booby-trapped or worse, I just can't tell from these screenshots. This view of the crop fields from the game room inside one of the side annexes of the main structure is the money shot. it's pure gold desktop wallpaper material. And that is all I have prepared for you in this episode of Player Construction Showcase. To get your own settlement or structure featured, send me screenshots or save files to the email in the description. Expect to see many new episodes as more save files hit my email box. Thank you for watching and happy gaming!